What's up, the Queer Union? This is Shy. I am 22. Yeah, I keep on forgetting that. I am from New York, and I identify as pansexual, and I'm an FTM. I wanted to just quickly make a video for you guys, kind of explaining why I've been in a MIA, and talking a little bit, pretty similar-ish. I don't know. Pretty much whatever I feel like. No, I'm just kidding. I don't know. I don't know what to talk about, and that's one of the reasons why I haven't made videos. But I'll tell you the main reason why I haven't made a video, so here we go. I've been on a rocky schedule recently. This week and a half-ish is Passover, which is a Jewish holiday, and my family's Jewish Orthodox. So I'm actually shockingly being pretty religious this year. No, it's actually, I'll talk about that after, about renewing my faith, faith and being LGBT. Actually, that'd be a good subject. I'll talk about that in a minute. I've actually been celebrating the holiday with my family. I've been spending with my family literally the whole time. It's kind of really nice for once, but that's one of the main reasons why I've been MIA. Other reasons why I've been MIA from videos is because I've been sick. I've been getting no sleep, but I'm working on that with my psychiatrist. Yes, I go to a psychiatrist, shockingly. So there's that. And I was sick with other stuff, allergies and whatnot. So between being sick, not getting sleep, and holidays, I've been MIA, but I'm back. I know this is not my regular day, but I wanted to give you guys something. Hopefully soon I'll get more ideas. I also want to warn you guys that within the next few months, I'm going to go MIA for about a week or two or so. And that's because of, about a week or two. And that's because of me planning to get top surgery. It's going to be within the next few months. I still haven't gotten a date. But that's why I'm going to be going MIA, but I thought that the viewers deserve it. So faith, religion, and LGBTQ, or whatever you want to call it. So, before I came out as trans, which I think this is a very important part to talk about, I identified as, pansexual or bisexual and female, or wasn't really sure. It's kind of funny because I, identify as female, but I went by male pronouns, and it really confused people, which was fun, because I like doing that stuff. I'm pretty much a gender, if you don't know about me, I consider myself a genderless FTM, my gender is Shy. So that's the matter to that. But with faith and with religion, because I grew up Jewish Orthodox, I grew up pretty religious, which is something when I tell people that I grew up Jewish Orthodox, they're like, "You grew up Jewish Orthodox?" That's when I tell people I have a learning disability. It's like, what, is there something that I have to, you read on my face saying that I grew up a certain way, that was my faith? You know, you can't tell people's faith by how they walk, by how they talk, by how they look. Sometimes people surprise you. I know a few people that you'd be like, they're Muslim, but yet they're Jewish. Or, I know a few people that, people assume that is Christian and is Jewish. So I grew up Jewish Orthodox. I don't know what that's supposed to look like. So if you know what that's supposed to look like, apparently you could tell me, because apparently there's a look. And I became less religious, after I dropped out of high school. As you guys know, I'm 22, so I've been out of high school for about 4 years now. I graduated in 2007, so it's almost 4 years. as a kid, I was decently religious, but that was because my family kind of forced me into it. But once I started getting older, I was like, maybe religion isn't for me, and slowly got less and less religious. After high school, when I was in pre-vocational school, if you don't know what pre-vocational school is, go Google it. It's a word that most people don't know. It's kind of hard to explain. And while I was there, and if you people think less of me because I went to pre-vocational school, feel free to think what you want and say what you want. I kind of started losing more and more faith in my religion. I became less and less religious. I stopped keeping the Sabbath. I kept less of the rules, I guess you could say, of Judaism. I also apologize for my birds being loud. It's actually like 4 a.m. It shouldn't be loud. So by the time I came to the time for me coming out, which was almost 3 years ago, I came out in general. A year after I graduated high school, approximately, I came out as being bisexual. I pretty much lost faith, and I pretty much lost religion. People don't understand that faith and religion is two separate things. So I didn't identify as not religious for a really long time. Identified as not agnostic, and whatnot. So let's fast forward to when I started identifying and started realizing that I was trans, and me actually started transitioning, which that was actually about 7 months fast forward, more than over a year fast forward after that, till I started taking testosterone. A few months on testosterone, it kind of really opened my eyes. I started feeling better in my body. I started feeling more okay in my body. I started being okay, more okay with who I was and who the person I am. And it's kind of weird how you see that imbalance, that it's like, oh wait, there really is a chemical imbalance somewhere inside of me. There's something wrong. And I felt the difference. People seen the difference, and I could feel the difference. If you saw my videos pre-T and post-T, you could even see the difference in my videos. I actually, post-T, because I'm almost 7 months on testosterone, have renewed my faith in religion. I'm doing more things associated with my religion. I'm more interested in my culture. I'm more interested of where I came from. More interested in my heritage. Post-puberty, and I think I know why, and I know why. And if any other guys who are watching this and is post-T, and this has happened to them, please comment, because it's kind of weird feeling alone. It's pretty much renewed my faith in Judaism. I don't think I'll ever be as religious as I was as a kid. Can't say never. I never say never with anything. But I plan to actually go on Birthright, which is basically, if you don't know what Birthright is, to simply say it's a trip where if you're between 18 and 24, you could go to Israel, and you basically get to learn about your heritage. If you're of Jewish descent, if you're not of Jewish descent, you can't go. There's certain programs and stuff like that. For example, by where I live, there's LGBT centers specifically for colored people. I can't go because I'm not colored, apparently. And it's kind of funny because some people consider Jewish people colored, but that's a whole other story that we don't need to go into. But that's the basis of what I wanted to talk about. I know I drawed it on to 9 minutes, but I haven't seen you guys in a while, so I hope everyone's doing well, and I'll see you guys soon.